Channel 8. You're watching Good Morning Washington.
But it's an after right now. Remember when there were roaming charges for your cell phone? Remember way back when?
Yeah.
Well, with time and technology comes change, and a trio of Georgetown prep grads are hard at work at the next revolution. The local company WiFiber, turning the Boston neighborhood in Arlington into a high-tech region. They've involved a system that provides free Wi-Fi and free charging stations for everyone. And joining us now to talk more about this concept is Adair Grover and Chase Donnelly, two of the three guys from Georgetown Prep to try to take over the world. Good to have you guys here. We saw some video as well that's actually, those were street lights. They're smart street lights, right?
Sir. Yes, sir.
How are they different from regular street lights?
Well, they're different. They have a multitude of functionality. They've got modular LED lighting, you've got 4K cameras, inbuilt gigabit access point, which doesn't just do client access, it replaces fiber. You can do point-to-point, point-to-multipoint, pure smart mesh as well, and a multitude of sensory IoT data.
Okay, so for the dumb guy walking down the street, okay, that sounds fantastic, but I'm walking down the street, what you're telling me is that I have Wi-Fi access not from my cell phone provider, but actually the Boston neighborhood. If I'm walking down the street
Correct.
Or whatever, it's right there.
Absolutely correct, yes.
Okay,
sir.
Okay. And no cost to me.
No cost to you.
It sounds like a wave of the future. I mean, this is kind of the next big thing. Are you guys on the cusp of something here? Is anyone else doing this kind of thing? Well, or
Chase likes to take those answers.
I suppose so, okay. and to that, there are some other players that are in the space, but they're doing things fundamentally different than the way that we're doing it. And the main differentiation is the fact that with our gear, if you have one input, let's just think of it loosely as the internet, right? You have one input coming in from either a fiber line or an Ethernet line like Comcast or Verizon or any of these guys. We're then wirelessly distributing that across three dozen wireless nodes.
Right.
And all they require is power.
Okay.
And
okay.
then from those nodes, we can wirelessly distribute all that signal to you, to me, to law enforcement, to any other smart city application.
You guys at the Consumer Electronics Show in February in Vegas, and won an award or was recognized out there, right? Yeah, Tell us about that.
It was actually a really unique process. We weren't expecting it, our first trade show, and so we got down there and we got nominated for Best of CES Smart City Award.
Wow.
And then we ended up winning the award. So it was really, really entertaining. And a truly honorable experience.
So you're started right now in Boston. I know we talked to Tina Leone, the CEO there. She's very excited about what you guys are doing and being a part of this process. How soon can this expand to other neighborhoods? And what do you have to do to get it in Roslyn, in Friendship Heights, wherever?
So we're actually taking on some initiatives right now to expand the Boston Mesh or the Boston Bid. It's called Blinked Canopy. And so we're taking some initiatives, working with the county on some initiatives to expand that out to different areas within Boston. And we're working with and have contact with some of the bids in the area, the business improvement districts, Roslyn, Clarendon, et cetera, to see what their appetite is for that type of initiative.
Is it a big money thing right now? Is it the biggest obstacle that you have?
You know, Chase spends a lot more time client-facing than I do. And just to be really frank, right?
Like ping pong.
He gives you all the tough questions. I can see that already.
He does, It's nice to defer those. But no, we certainly, we've been taking it out to you know, not just business improvement districts, but also to municipalities at both a city, state, county level. Oftentimes the cost can be not necessarily considerable, but there can be a limitation when you have a need for high amounts of bandwidth. And so to distribute a ton of signal out to you and to me and to thousands of people simultaneously, you have to have a ton of capacity coming in. And so one of the benefits of going to a municipal route, whether it's a city or a county or a state, is that they have their own infrastructure that we can play off of, and then we can wirelessly distribute that wherever need be.
It's exciting stuff. I know Georgetown Prep, very excited that you're representing the school very well. And good luck with this in all the neighborhoods as you get grow and come back and see us again.
We really appreciate it. Thanks for having us on.
All right, Darren Chase, WiFiber. Go to Boston, get free Wi-Fi. It's on them. 8:14 right now. More Good Morning Washington coming up after a break. Stay with us.